the playing field is level. Companies are as, apart from the brand recall, the companies are as equal in terms of using social media as a startup. Depends how innovatively or creatively a startup uses a certain medium or a tool that can lead to further. So do you guys, who knows what is a social media startup? A social media startup.
Creating a page on
Facebook?
No. Startup is a company.
Ideally a seed capital there.
Yeah.
And a bit of a business.
Yeah, startup is definitely a company, but a social media startup is what we...
Company which has actually launched itself on the social media platforms, let's say Facebook only, and probably through that and through the approach of the market strategy that they've utilized, they managed to amass the same kind of population come onto their site, onto their social site, rather than coming to the website, and yet effectively translating into value sales.
Now, assuming if we were to talk about, there are limited number of startups, social media startups when you talk about bias. And if we were to talk about what are the entry barriers, or like why don't people start off?
There's no seed capital required when it comes to social media startups, but the idea is that, for example, coming up with a brand, a brilliant idea of some niche,
People are expert on one side of things. Usually they are not expert on another side of things.
I think that would come under the skill set and that can be tackled through collaboration if required. But are there any other things actually stopping people from going? I do agree that ideas and innovation is one thing, but is there any other thing that's stopping people?
The fear of going ahead with startup is what stops some companies.
But then there's no investment. I don't think there's a fear.
No, they're scared of failing.
First of all, I don't understand why there is no investment. I mean, well, most of them, it may not require, but it does actually.
It does, yes, to an extent, but comparatively,
way lesser than
something that is more physical in terms of, because if you're setting up something physically, you need to invest in infrastructure as well as other hiring more people as compared to people you would need for a social media startup.
I thought you were
People underestimate it compared to the convention.
Yeah, I think it's about the mindset then. Would it be about the mindset?
Yeah.
Because at the end of the day, if it's about the mindset, how would we change that mindset if you were to change it? Because again,
ideas are started because of the mindset. So obviously, unless and until you have that idea which is coming through, that's appropriate mindset.
I was coming to that. Now, for example, if we were to talk about how we should how we can grow, how we can help to increase the social media startup rate that is in Pakistan at this point. I think it's nearly non-existent at this point in time. But people are there have been some startups, like for example, Food Connection Pakistan is one. There's another one called Groupen that Islamabad is. Similarly, there are other websites. But how can we actually encourage people to increase?
I'm not to the level where people are, for example, what they usually communicate with. For example, if they're not using the social network to communicate, get them down to the level that they actually can communicate. Otherwise, there's no other way. Otherwise, you're practically, and give them examples of exactly what's happening.
Also, you can also
maybe help them out, and then automatically that chain will actually just expand. Just take on.
Also, you can incentivize it.
Incentivizing is interesting.
Incentivize a startup.
But
I'm not saying you incentivize a startup. You incentivize people. You tell them the benefit of it. People are motivated by their interest as well. You know, that keeps them going. That's even cycle. So that's how it is.
That's one thing.
So institutes.
Institutes. is an interesting idea.
Addition in
the
curriculum.
Best thing is to start.
Yes, that's important. I mean, I try to incorporate blogging and social media and everything in the other course curriculum, but they were not. Again, there was a mindset problem there.
I would suggest that we should not discourage the new media. We should, because people usually take a shift towards the traditional media. We have to make it, we have to have involved with someone to make them know and understand that it's not wrong, it's something which would be helping them. Because people, as I said, they are afraid of trying new things out. So they should not be afraid of change. There should be no fear, they should be encouraged. And as I said, no success stories and all that. So you just give them a gentle nudge.
That's interesting. I think, again, institutes one is important, encouraging is important, but then again, we need a platform in terms of encouraging, right? So I think in terms of that, we could, just a wide shot, probably we could like work around and create an organization that does that. Moving on to, for example, what makes a social media tool relevant for a specific business? I mean, for example, if you want to use Facebook for your business, why do you want to use Facebook? Just a thought.
It's easier to get feedback when it comes to consumers and customers. And if they can just post things to
What about Twitter?
Twitter, in that case,
it's the same thing. But then again, I mean,
they
could
actually give you the feedback straight away, fast.
Yeah.
Can I button and answer this one? It all depends on your audience. All marketers, majority of the marketers in Pakistan make this mess up. They want to use media, but you do not understand the consumer. It's all about the consumer. If your customer likes to read billboards, you go billboards. If your customer reads Masjid ke baare badhne wala kharcha, please do that.
Absolutely. I was coming to the fact that, there are a lot of,
main purpose is to connect with your target audience.
When you start up with a question that how you're going to use this social media to promote your business, this was the answer.
My
customer range or the target market is not like I'm going to do it on Facebook.
Absolutely. So, relevance. I mean, what is relevant to you? Even if social media is relevant, that's the first thing. However, you have this advantage that you can actually use it to create awareness for free. You can use it to market your products and everything, but then again, is it relevant? That's important to understand. I mean, whatever business you have, for example, you actually would need to understand the fact. For example, if we were to talk about, just a random talk on, for example, if I were to throw a product and we make a social media strategy for that, I mean, ice cream that never melts. For example, there's a startup who created, they had an investment, they put all their investment in R&D and actually made a product that's very cool and everything. And
but half the fun of ice cream is that it melts in your mouth.
Yeah, right? So I think that's a good tagline. But then again, what social media strategy would we craft for it? I mean, if I were to ask you, if we were to talk about selecting a social media tool or social media tools in this case,
you should target people that don't get brain freeze.
Okay. Yeah. Absolutely. Yeah.
Click like, and you will get a free cup of that ice cream.
Love you. Likes. Oh my god, that's interesting.
Let me tell you one thing. This is one of the best platform. The cost-effective medium of communication.
Yeah.
Where you can easily connect with your audience.
Absolutely.
Two-way communication, not a single way. Because the previous traditional media gave you this one-way medium of communication.
Bilkul, because you just
is different.
Absolutely. मतलब पहले ही होता था कि आपको जो traditional media just told you stuff and you had to listen. आप अगर बात करते थे.
This is the main part was engaging, connecting and collaborating.
Absolutely. So collaborating. आप पहले ही होता था ना कि even if you wanted to revolt, आपने घरवालों से बोलते हैं कि you should probably go and talk to your friends and that's it.
That's why.
Now you can go online and they take the cab or whatever the client is or whatever.
Saroj, what you were saying about relevance.
Yeah.
Supposing you are trying to sell pesticides to farmers who are not online,
yeah.
And it doesn't matter.
Yeah, it doesn't matter. Then again, at that point in time, it's like going on Facebook or social media doesn't matter.
So know your customer is always right.
Absolutely. In that case, yes, because at the end of the day, again, aapki jo product hai, usse relevant hona bahut zaruri hai. Again, if social media is not relevant, then you shouldn't actually think about it. That's the best way to go. And then, us case mein agar TV bhi hoga, radio bhi, that would be terrestrial, not satellite channel, because then we need to reach the
can you give an example of a stunt which has gone wrong? You know, one of the local brands who use social media to promote something like Nando's did. You know, they promoted something and it went all wrong.
There was one example of, I don't know if I should name a brand, but Jazz Jazzla.
Go ahead.
I mean, a copy logo.
Yeah.
I mean, that was crazy. I mean, and I picked up the news very late, maybe 15 days after the login, but I literally patched over my blog. And everyone on, like, from the industry actually were on me.
Here's insight.
Me on
Here's some insight. I met the person who was looking after the Jazz Jazzla brand.
Okay.
And I
from
asked
the agency or Mobilink?
From Mobilink.
Okay.
I met them in Karachi. And I met her. And asked, so what's with your logo? She said, what's with logo? I said, well, it's nice and colorful and it's reeks of, you know, lack of originality.
Yeah.
And yeah, we just want to make sure, okay, when someone type crazy cool logo, our logo will show up on top. I mean, listen, but when someone has crazy cool logo in Google, your logo still doesn't show up on top. It's the other company.
Absolutely.
And then she said, oh yeah, I know it's a tutorial to build a logo. I said, no. So you have your research wrong. The tutorial that was famous was by this guy called Abudizo, probably Libya or somewhere, right? And he wrote a tutorial. But the logo he was trying to teach people to draw was of Zagora, which is a Brazilian company. So even Mobilink had the research wrong on the logo that they gave.
I mean, whoever read that post,
how silly
right?
can they
be? Absolutely, whoever read that post knew it was a copy logo.
Yeah,
right? Like, it was simply made from that tutorial. They didn't realize, I mean, they just copied the tutorial like from that tutorial, and that was it. They didn't realize,
like,
probably they didn't read what
it looked like. A visualizer read the tutorial and tried to draw something, and maybe it got selected.
Absolutely.
They resembled the zone logo. So
I think
the zone logo. So that was
the
you forgot the example of Nando's, where they had this thing where you like a nice catchy tagline or something, and what happened later was that they promised a free meal to the person, and at the end they said, okay, you have to buy three meals before you get your meal. So they ended up.
Oh yes, that happened to my friend, and
that was
blasted them on a blog.
That was lack of conditional clarity. You're supposed to write down conditions clear in advance.
Absolutely, I think the brands missed that, and then
that's their problem.
Yeah,
that's their problem. If people don't read, that's their problem.
Yeah, absolutely. I think the uski wajah se major problem hoti hai. That is that if wahan pe agar mentioned hai terms and conditions, then it's okay because the brand is safe. Right, because they already mentioned the terms and conditions. But at the end of the day, if they don't mention that, and people go there, like for example, my friend went there and he had to buy three meals to avail that discount. I mean, that was crazy. Achha, coming back to actually how we should think of a social media strategy when we're planning for it. The first we need to ask some questions from ourselves, as abhi relevance ki baat kar rahe the, ki relevance hai ya nahi hai. Again, first of all, what's my goal? I mean, first of all, if that product is relevant to go on social media, should you even market that product on social media? That's one. Secondly, what's your goal for that product? If you want to get awareness, do you want to connect with the audiences that are available on Facebook, or like, does your audience even exist on Facebook? That's the question. Again, or is it for only on online presence? Is it for image or credibility? Again, moving on, is it for engagement or interaction? A lot of brands, I mean, already are very popular. But then they want to like interact with their consumers. They want their consumers to interact probably through like for customer support maybe, or to get their feedback, or to engage them on other metrics. And then probably they also require feedback, which is an extended version of it. I mean, for example, if they have a product, they want some feedback from it. I mean, probably they would want that. They would go for that. That's important. Moving on again. Also then, what content are your customers creating? That's again an extended version when you go into social media. I mean, if you are a famous brand, or if you are a known brand, or if you are a known starter, at the end of the day, then you need to know if your customers are writing about you, what are they writing about you? That's important. Then again, what are they interested in? I mean, if they are writing about you, I mean, good or bad, I mean, if, for example, if you're offering a blue like color t-shirt, if you're a t-shirt startup, if you're offering a blue color t-shirt but your customers like a red one, and you don't offer that, and they're actually asking for a similar design in a red t-shirt but not in a blue one. So I mean, it's about what their likes and dislikes are, and then this can actually help you get feedback as well as move on further. Again, an important thing is to listen. I mean, when you're on social media, I mean, the traditional media, the problem was that they used to direct whatever they want to do. And I shouldn't quote this example because I'm not usually allowed to quote this, but now I can. So I would.
You can quote anything you want in this summit.
I would now because I can. I mean, the example of the guy who went to the Claire Mala show, I think that piece probably got really famous. Now, the problem that in that case was, for example, even after a year later, we were sitting in the event talking to them to actually go on social media and they were at least build their presence. Now, the problem with them was, I mean, if you go on social media, people will talk bad about you. Right? I mean, they don't know that people have already been talking about what they did.
They don't know what Unilever does globally. Unilever Pakistan doesn't know what Unilever does globally.
They do. By the end of the day, the problem is that they want to close their ears and eyes. They don't want to listen and see what's happening. They just want to direct their message. I mean, they are educated people, young people, yet they don't want to go ahead with that.
No, but trust me, there are people waiting for them to come back into social
media. Huh? No, Walls is there, right? There are other Unilever brands that are already there.
Yeah.
Walls,
they are on social media.
There's so many brands.
Talk about Claire. Because there are different branding, especially in Claire's case, they've gone really sensitive. Because, I mean, like that was a mishap, whatever that happened. In that case, they've gone really,
they don't want to face the music.
Yeah, I'd say that. I mean, they don't want to face it that how people will react, how the bloggers will react, how the people on Twitter will react to that, even after a year or two that came. So again, coming back to the point that listening to consumers is very important. Talking to them, engaging with them is important. And then actually embracing them and actually after solving their problems through customer support or actually listening to them, it's about actually building a long-term relationship with your customer. That's what social media is about, to connect with them and going ahead forward. So again, at the end of the day, it's about no complex strategies, or I'd say more complex strategies in a way, because it's all about managing human nature. It's not just one person, it's everyone. So you need to be careful in whatever you're saying, you need to be careful in whatever you're doing. You actually need to be careful in how you're handling, for example, if there's a crisis, if you want to say anything, if you want to communicate a message in terms of whatever you have, it's about how you're going ahead with that. You have to be careful in selecting words when you're doing it. I mean, I'm talking in terms of a brand perspective, because I've known brand managers from different companies and actually having the same, mindset with respect to bloggers, because they think that, bloggers would write anything they want to and they won't listen to anything. I mean, they don't understand the point that they write whatever is true. They write whatever they feel, and if they write whatever they feel, they write about their experience. That's important. So again, it's basically, to sum this up, it's about listening to your, to the relevant customers and the conversations they're involved in. And then starting authentic conversations regarding your startups. That's another one. Similarly, you need to engage with them. And finally, you need to invest your personal time and efforts to actually build that relationship up over time. That's more or less about it. Ending it up. It's not a very long session, I'm just ending it up. A few mistakes that people do is when they're planning a social media strategy is they dive into it without a plan. Without a strategic plan, without a proper plan to actually manage, they dive into it without a crisis management plan or an alternate contingency plan that they should have. And then again, they're unfocused. For example, a lot of Facebook pages, I mean, how many of you are following Facebook pages in Pakistan? I mean, Facebook pages of brands, right? I mean, a lot of pages, I've seen them, they usually have the same status. Across the board. I mean, that's my observation. For example,
only a few companies.
I mean, it's not relevant. I mean, whatever they're actually updating, it's not relevant. That's what the perception that a lot of people, even my friends, got. For example, there's another strategy that social media companies are using currently in Pakistan is they hire a lot of students from colleges who have 400 or 500 friends on Facebook. And they pay them per status of a week, or they give them credit for a week. I happened to teach about 2 years back, and then what happened, all my students were actually posting the same status for 2 weeks, 10 times a day, and it was crazy. Because at the end of the day, it is paid, it is not social media, and it is again creating a nuisance, and I had to block a lot of them because of this status updates, same status updates for weeks coming on my status bar. So at time, and even brands are willing to pay for that. I mean, my point is, at the end of the day, you have to be careful in what you're using, how you're going about the social media strategy, and if you're paying for something, it's okay, but then again, you need to be careful in what you're doing. That's what I was about to
next. You still have 8 minutes left.
I don't know.